For our final tutorial segment, we'll take a brief tour of the Health InfoNet website. First, let's look at the homepage at www.healthinfonet.org. Notice that the central portion of the page is devoted to marketing our skills as information professionals in helping users find just the information that they need for their health questions. Below these introductory paragraphs is our disclaimer, reminding users that the materials provided by Health InfoNet should not be interpreted as medical advice. At the bottom of this page is the Feature of the Month, which links to a news item on the news page. Notice other recent news items linked to the right of the page, just over the chat link and photo. At the top of the right-hand section is a link to our Facebook page. If you haven't yet liked the Health InfoNet Facebook page, please do so. Moving over to the left-hand sidebar, notice the navigation links to other important sections of the site, including another chat reference link, a page of resources, and information specifically for librarians, a link to the InfoNet database of health services, and a page with links to reliable online health information sources. We'll go over each of these pages in a little while. There are additional navigation tabs across the top of the home page, including one to an About Us page, another Contact Us page link, as well as the previously mentioned News page. The Health InfoNet logo at the top of the page is a link back to the home page in addition to the Home tab on the navigation bar. Also notice that in the upper right-hand corner, users may select another language besides English from the Google Translation pull-down menu. This was provided in lieu of a mirror site in Spanish, for example. While it's not a perfect alternative, it's the best we can offer at this time due to our limited funds. Finally, note the links at the bottom left to our supporting organizations, as well as our policies and linking guidelines. As far as privacy, our policy is that we only collect personal identification in order to get requested health information to the user, but we do not hold on to this information, nor do we ever provide such information to third parties for any reason. In terms of accessibility, we make every effort to make the information and links on the site easily available to users with disabilities. Okay, now, let's go to the Resources for Librarians page. In a nutshell, this page is intended to help librarians assist their users in locating reliable resources to answer their health questions. As you can see, this includes links to some standard health information websites and directories on the right. There are some tips for using Google to find health information online if and when the usual sources such as Medline Plus come up short. Also, we've provided a number of PDF documents and handouts to download to use yourself or provide your users. We hope you'll find these resources useful, and also that you'll let us know if you have any questions or concerns about any of these materials. We definitely want your feedback. Next, we'll look at another major feature of the Health InfoNet website, the Alabama Health Services Database. This feature allows residents to search for health services in their location relevant to their health needs. First, let's click on the Search for Alabama Health Services link in the left-hand sidebar. We are now presented with a list of search options, as well as the disclaimer again about not confusing our inclusion of a service in the database with recommendation. Generally, our search options are either searching by geographic location here on the left, or searching by type of service or health issue on the right. In addition, of course, there is the option of using the search box at the top right. However, let's start by clicking on the Find Health Topic link under Topics and Services column. When we do, we're presented with an alphabetical navigational links, and the A topics are listed as default. As you can see, there are a number of topics just under the A's to choose from. Let's try looking for an unfortunately common health issue here in Alabama, diabetes. If you click on the D in the alphabetical navigational links, you can then click on diabetes from the menu. There is a variety of health services associated with diabetes, and that shows in the number of results presented from this search, over 1,000. We could now limit by geographic area from these results if we choose. Let's look at the results just in Birmingham. We can see there is still a wide variety of services with at least a passing relevance to diabetes just in Birmingham, from home health services to internal medicine practices to podiatrists, to the local American Diabetes Association office. If we wanted to, we could limit further within these results by clicking on one of the types of service limits under Service Type on the left. For example, if someone were looking for a podiatrist in Birmingham to help someone avoid diabetic foot problems, there seem to be quite a few in the area. However, please note one thing at this point in our demonstration of this database. Individual healthcare practitioners of any kind are not typically included in the Health InfoNet database unless it is a named practice, such as Russellville Pediatrics, instead of a doctor someone. For more comprehensive directories of individual practitioners, we encourage you to consult professional directories, such as the AMA Doctor Finder. If you need help locating a particular type of health professional directory, the medical librarians at the University of Alabama in Birmingham and the University of South Alabama are happy to help you. Just go here. Getting back to our search for diabetes service providers on this site, we could try to go a different route and search first by service type and then health topic. This time, if we searched by service type, then clicked on P, and then podiatrists, we could again limit by geographic area or service topic on the left, similar to the way we did so with the health topic search for diabetes. For example, we can see that there are 95 of these podiatrists included in the database that address diabetes. We could then limit further by geographic area. And we'll find the 17 podiatrists that practice in the Birmingham area. But what about that search box option? Certainly, we can just use the search box to find services by keyword. Then we could limit the results, similar to the way we did using the other database options. However, unless you are familiar with the indexing terms used in this database, we advise you to start by using the Find It features already demonstrated. Since the search engine for the site is not as intuitive as we'd like, if you search the wrong keyword, in this case if you put in podiatrist, you'll come up short, as you can see here. However, searching podiatrists works just fine. Another tip to using the search box to find services is to use the asterisk truncation symbol with roots of words, like diabetes. This will bring up results for diabetes, diabetic, diabetics, and so forth. One final note about this database of health services. Free or low-cost clinics for the uninsured are listed under the service type heading, Community Clinics. And you'll see there are 163 of these statewide. Identifying these types of services for Alabama residents who may be uninsured is a priority task for the Health InfoNet project. If you know of any such services in your area that you are unable to find in the database, please notify the project administrators through the Contact Us page on the site. We won't spend much time on the other parts of the site, which are hopefully self-explanatory, the About Us, News, and the Health Information web pages. We do encourage you and your users to make use of the chat reference. And the web email form on the Contact Us page. You can submit requests for help with finding health information to your medical librarian partners and the Health InfoNet project. We make it our goal to respond to any Health InfoNet questions, either via web form, email, or phone within 24 hours. Naturally, chat questions are answered almost immediately whenever chat is open, which is usually during normal business hours. After hours, you will get a convenient email link directly from the chat box window. I hope you have found this segment on the Health InfoNet website helpful and that you'll return to the site often when helping users with health questions. For now, I encourage you to take the brief quiz on this segment available on the slide. After this segment, you'll find closing remarks by Kay Hogan Smith and an evaluation form. And that will conclude this tutorial.